Which region is leading the way in robotaxis? You talked about all the different cities around the world where you're operating. Which region has the strongest and most supportive regulatory environment?
So that's very interesting that actually Germany, with its, let's say, traditional automotive industry, has put a stake in the ground this year. So 28th of July of 2021, Germany has enacted a new legislation for autonomous driving for level four, level five. And this means that right now it's together with France, actually the first country where you can actually do a full level four type approval of the vehicle. And it's not just an exception approval, but it's actually an approval which allows you to deploy and scale. And we are just waiting for the technical regulation to be passed through the Senate. We expect this to happen in the next few weeks. And then the whole process of approval will actually start. So Europe, in this sense, is kind of leading the way. And we expect the next step to be the European Union and EU 27 to have such regulation. And in parallel, of course, there will be some competition worldwide, like Singapore and other markets. And we hope that, you know, the US will follow soon as well with a federal regulation. And we can definitely just recommend, you know, regulators, legislators around the world to actually make this step and actually have a federal legislation and regulation in place.
So in terms of commercialization and the industry, you see Europe as being ahead of the United States and other regions?
So at least, you know, having this this framework, right, which is important, so that it's not like, you know, a different, let's say, regulation in like 50 different states. So right now, what we have in the US, we have, of course, several states which have frameworks in place, but it's very different. In California versus, let's say, Texas or New York State and so on. So that's why we are very much, for federal level legislation and regulation. And therefore, I think this is important, you know, for both for technology providers, for automotive manufacturers, as well as for consumers, because, you know, at the end of the day, you want to be able to use, you know, the same apps traveling, you know, from A to B, and then be able to have access to these services. And I think accessibility is another important topic also, you know, which will impact the design of the vehicles of the future to really have accessible services, inclusive mobility for all.
JJ, everyone I speak to around the world has the same question. When do commercial robo-taxis actually become real?
So we see actually 2022 till 2025, this phase, the next 3 years, as actually the most important for these commercial robotaxi, robo shuttle services. So, of course, we need regulatory approval, and there is this dependency to receive that. Therefore, basically, I expect this, you know, to be in somewhere in 22 or latest 2023 when these commercial deployments, you know, will start and then basically scale. From there, it's all about scaling. And Mobileye is all about safety, number one, and scaling, number two. Everything we do is about scaling and safety. And I think this is key to success.
So let's bring this full circle. How does the project in Paris help you achieve those long-term goals?
So it definitely helps us to have a full end-to-end rider experience using the Moovit app, and then basically having the full A to B, ride-hailing experience with the autonomous vehicle. Now in Paris, it's still with safety drivers, and it will certainly help us, you know, to get feedback from riders, to get experience in, you know, one of the most complex driving environments. It's even crazier driving than New York City. When we were in New York this year, I already thought this is the peak, but actually Paris tops that. And we have actually chosen these locations and these cities. You know, we go to these most dense and most complex environments even first, and we think this is the right approach. And then, for example, looking at Tokyo, maybe just as another example, in Tokyo, left side driving. So that means we get a lot of experience there, you know, for the UK, for, you know, Singapore, Australia, New Zealand. So I think you need to look at this on a global map and on a global scale.